Been waiting for this video for days, and now it's here. Actually, not days, it's been weeks, but whatever. Welcome everyone to allengesgo.son Toys. In today's review, I will be reviewing toys. But today, I have a special guest with me. The world's best person ever, best friend in the world. I present you, Tencent. What? Sorry, I just got confused. Tencent just arrived here out of nowhere. I'm very sorry about that. I present you, Chomis. What? No, sorry about that. Officially, I present you, Jack Strange.
Hey y'all, Jack's here. And I'll be joining Trainboy 33 today as we review these wonderful toy trains with faces. Let's begin. Alright, first we have the new Push Along James, which I guess you could say it's alright, because it looks very accurate to the reboot. I just don't like how the reboot James looks like. Just that face does not scream James to me. But I guess that's just a problem with the reboot and not the toy.
Push Along Sandy. If I'm being honest, Sandy's kinda cute and I like her model, and I'm gonna buy it for sure. But I don't know. It's accurate, of course. It's really, really accurate to, well, you know, the Sandy of the show. But I don't know, it's weird. It's a weird feeling I have about it. Honestly, it's quite good at the same time bad, if that makes any sense. I don't know.
Alright, next up we have the Push Along Kenji, which looks really weird to me because in the toy, he's blue with a white stripe, but in the show, he's silver with a white stripe. Also got a clown on this man's face for looking like he makes a living out of stealing Happy Meals.
Carly. Why is she a railway vehicle when she should be a dark side? Besides that, why is Carly a railway engine? Like, seriously, who thought it was a great idea to turn on Crane, who was previously shown many times on a dark side, who can move from side to side somehow, is now an engine, you're telling me? Well, poor Cranky, now she's short.
Could we have Carly? Wait, no, not that one. Oh, good God, not that one either. Alright, finally, there's Strike Master Carly. And a lot of the criticism I have for this model is not about the model itself, it's more about how she looks in the show. I just don't understand why they decided to make Carly a rail vehicle.
The Truck Master Gordon is interesting. He's really big, I can see that, and considering the models, the, you know, Truck Master Thomas and Percy are quite big, I'm assuming this must be even bigger, and for James as well. Honestly, I don't know what to say. Gordon looks good at the same time bad, that makes any sense. I think Gordon is the only character that has brains in the show, if I'm being honest, though I might buy this. But yeah, overall, I don't know. It's a weird feeling I have of it.
And finally, we have the Trackmaster Metallic 4-pack. And all of these have the same problems as I do with the other reboot merch. Which is that they all look really accurate to the reboot design. But the reboot design sucks. So in turn, these all look bad too. And don't even get me started on these discount warp pipe looking funnels they have over here. Or how the fact that they don't even have the metallic on the side.
And that is all for today. Thank you, Jax, for being here. I really appreciate your Sonic appearance out of nowhere. As I said, you gotta go fast, so I'm gonna leave you for now. And of course, subscribe to the channel. And I'm gonna let those Sonic himself, man, speak himself. What?
But yeah, overall, I had a pretty fun time reviewing these marketable pieces of plastic with you, Trainboy. Thanks for having me on. And it would also be pretty cool if you subscribed to my channel on YouTube at Jack Trains.
Thank you all for watching. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye, everyone.